Hello, my name is Bascon Lijnsluiper. I'm a collector of vintage video games like MSX and Videopack. I live in the Netherlands. Now I have here a Philips NMS 8280. This one, the owner is Edos, Edo van Santen from the Netherlands. And he asked me, can you change it to 7 MHz? In this video, I want to show you how to change this MSX computer to 7 MHz. Have fun with watching this video. This is the complete package of the 7 MHz. It's a pre-assembled PCB with a clock chip and under the PCB a new Z80 with the wires to the LED and switch, an IC socket, a switch with built-in LED, a resistor array, some isolation material and a piece of wire. To start with this modification, you have to open this computer and almost a complete disassembling from this beautiful video MSX computer. Be careful with the front panel, it's a very weak part. Let's start with the backside. On the backside you will find 5 screws. And at the bottom, you'll find another 2. Now, you can slide off the top case. This Philips 8280 is the latest version. There are a few things different. First, the video board. It's the modern version with a double-sided PCB. A better power supply and the new disk drives. There is no difference with building in the 7 MHz. But be careful with the cables. For the older versions there are more cables. Please look at the numbers on the PCB and on the cables to put it back. To solder in, to build in, it's exactly the same for all types Philips NMS 8280. Remove the metal bar. It 4 screws. Remove the cooling plate on the top of the disk drives. The disk drive, complete with the front panel, is mounted with 4 screws. 2 on the back side and 2 on the front side. then you can slide the front panel complete with the disk drives a few centimeters. Remove all cables. Two disk drive cables. And two power cables. Then you can move the front panel on this way. Please remove all cables with connectors. A few to the main board, a few to the video board. Remove the big connector from the power board so you can make some space for the on-off switch cable. And here is another one. And you can take off the complete front panel with all cables and disk drives. Now we have to remove the video board. Remove all the cables from the board with all the connectors. There are many cables. And now you can remove this complete board with three screws on the left side and two on the right side. Remove the back panel a little bit, so you have now enough space to take out this PCB. Remove all the cables. And now it's time to remove the main PCB. A lot of screws. You see, here is a new disk room. If you have a very old one, it could give problems with the 7 MHz. then you can take out this mainboard and take out the big connector on the cartridge slot. And this computer is empty. This is the complete mainboard. I will explain some parts. This is the engine for the sound, keyboard. This is the disk controller, the MSX1 ROM, modified MSX2 ROM, the new disk ROM, video RAM, RAM, video chip, clock chip, the battery and the Z80. This Z80 has to be removed from this board. Now I can desolder all the remaining pins. Please do not try to unsolder the Z80. If you have a lot of damage on the mainboard, it's almost not possible to repair. And if you want to buy a new Z80, it's a few euros, so it's not worth to save the chip. And now the second row. And take your time. Do the same job with this resistor array. It's nearby the keyboard connector. I bent it a few times because the legs are very short finally, the legs are breaking. It's coming. I can take out the remaining pins with my tweezer. It's a little bit harder as the Z80. But again, take your time. Only one. Now I have to clean the solder spots. I always use some new solder to mix it with the old solder. Let's start with this resistor array. And with an old toothbrush, I clean the empty place of this resistor array. New solder. And clean all the 40 holes. And clean it with a toothbrush. I've here the new resistor array. Place it on the right direction. Pin 1 is on the left side with the little square. The next step is the IC socket for the 7 MHz modification. The next step is shorten pin 9 of IC number 109. Do the same with IC 148 pin 11. On the bottom of this PCB you can make a connection of pin 11 from IC 148. So this one is not connected to the chip anymore. And make a wire to G106 pin 1. Now to place the PCB for the 7 MHz on the right position. The diodes to the right side, to the outside of the board. Then solder a wire on IC 155, it's here, on pin 2, and bring this wire to one of the three diodes on the right side of the Z80 Turbo 7 MHz processor. And solder it to one of the three diodes. Not the first, not the last one. They are used. One of the middle. I have here the front panel with the disk drives. And I make a choose to put in a switch with LED in the front panel. Of course, you can place it everywhere where you want. But if you want to do it in the front panel, remove all the parts from the front panel, then there is almost no chance you get some damage to the parts or to the front panel. I will remove the three sliders of the front. Then, in this case, the cooling parts from the disk drive, with only two little screws. Then I get some access to the screws on the front, here, but two screws on the right side. Two on the left side. And one on the bottom. Then removing the on-off switch with two screws, with a few turns on the one screw, a few turns on the other screw, and so on till it comes loose. And the front panel with some screws to this PCB, the front PCB. And I can take out this very long and small PCB. I want to make here the hole for the switch. Be careful, front is very weak. Take your time. I do not drill. In this front I use my soldering iron, an old one, to make a few holes. It smells very nicely here. Now I can make the hole on the right size. This is the right size. I want to mount it later when I assemble the computer again. Then the wire goes to the hole and I can solder it outside the computer. It's easier. Let's start with the front PCB. Be careful with the wires. Then the on-off switch. Few turns one side, few turns other side, and so on. Then the disk drives. With four bigger screws and one small longer screw. Finally, for this front panel, the cooling parts for the disk drive. Here I have the bottom case for the computer. First start with the cable on the cartridge slots. And then the PCB fits. Now all screws. And there are many.
Now it's time for all the cables. A lot of cables and also an extra one for the 7 MHz. So, bend them a little bit in the corner and then we can mount the video PCB. Five screws, two on the right side, three on the left side. And now all cables on the right positions. These two are for the disk drives. With the front panel the same, connect all the cables and I will start with the on-off switch. and the last one. It's full of cables, the Philips 8280. Then the 7 MHz cable, a little bit to its position. Then together the two drives on top of all cables. Squeeze it together. Be careful. Like this way. Screw the front panel with two screws on the front, two on the back side of the disk drive. And the next one on the front panel. And another one on the other side. First start with connecting the power cables on both disk drives. This is a new type disk drive. This one is different for connection than the original one. The original disk drive you have to do on this way, straight. But for this new type you have to be twist the cable. You also have to do it for new disk drives. If you make the wrong connection, the drive LED is continuous burning. So then you know you have to twist the cable. So this is the normal way, but in this case I have to twist it for 180 degrees. But there's also a notch and it fits on only one way. So this is the normal way. Now I have to twist it and then it should fit. The next step is the bar and the cooling plate. Let's start with the cooling plate. I want to use some new tape. And then the metal bar. With four screws. I soldered the wires on the switch with LED. I use some insulation material.
How do you have to connect this cable to the switch with LED? I have two variations. I have two different versions of 7 MHz with the coloring of the wires. The red or the white wire is the positive side of the LED. The brown or the black wire is the negative side of the LED. The orange and yellow pair is a switch, and in my case is the gray and purple pair is for the switch. Now I can put in the switch into the front in the big hole I made. Now I can close the case of this nice computer and I can have a test with it. Five black screws on the back side and two on the bottom. Here you see the switch. When I turn on the computer, when the switch is off, the computer is working on a normal speed of 3.5 MHz. I can switch it on. You see a red light is burning. Now the 7 MHz is working. It's allowed to switch when the computer is turned on. Let's try with some software. Let's try the 7 MHz with an SSC game. This is the normal speed. Now I switch it over to 7 MHz. And it sounds very strange. 7 MHz is not made for music. Let's try with the little basic program. This is the normal speed. This is 7 MHz. A big difference. Normal speed, 7 MHz. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time in a new video.